Learn how to use Citus to scale out Postgres this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Claire, a program manager and leader on the Citus team at Microsoft. Hi, Claire, how's it going?
Good. Happy to be here.
We are happy to have you here. And Claire, before we get into the topic for today, I would love if you could give us a brief intro on what you do.
What do I do? I do all sorts of things. I'm on the Citus open source team. Citus is an extension of Postgres. And I do a lot of work to help people discover Citus, learn about what it is, how it works, why they should care, how Citus can help them. The engineers that I work with are spread actually all over the globe in like 5 or 6 different countries. So in my work at Microsoft, I end up with early morning meetings and late night meetings. And I'm based in California. And yeah, I've been doing this at Microsoft for about 2.5 years, and I was at Citus before the acquisition for a couple of years before that.
Awesome. Cool. Well, we're excited to have you on the show. And I think kind of you're alluding to what my first question is, which is really like, can you tell us a little bit of more about what is Citus?
Absolutely. So Citus is an extension to Postgres. Postgres, I think many of your viewers know, it's, you know, an open source database, hugely popular, used by people and applications all around the globe. I can bring up a slide too, if we want to display.
Sure.
Let me click ahead to this guy. Oh, and I'm on the Postgres team at Microsoft, obviously. But Citus is an open source extension to Postgres. And what Citus does is it transforms Postgres into a distributed database. And it's super useful for applications that need scale that goes beyond a single database server. They need more memory, they need more compute. Maybe those applications are really growing like gangbusters with not just more data, but more users, more activity, more features, things like that. And so Citus enables you to continue to use Postgres, but as a distributed cluster. And so especially for applications that have already started using Postgres from the very beginning, Citus can be an incredibly transformative way to grow that app.
Awesome.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, no, that makes a lot of sense. You know, one question you talked about distributed, and I think a lot of that has to do with sharding. Can you tell us a little bit about how like sharding plays into Citus and also like what kind of applications you see a lot of people using this for?
Yeah, I can definitely do that. And before I do, I just want to pop this up on the screen just to drive home the point that Citus is an open source extension. And this is just a screenshot of the GitHub repo where you can find, you know, all the discussions and the activity and the things that the engineers are doing on the project. So Citus is also available on Azure as well as a managed service, which is incredibly useful to people who run their applications in the cloud on Azure. But you wanted to know about what use cases or what applications? Repeat your question, please.
Yeah, sure. I was asking, you know, what kind of applications do you see sharding Postgres with Citus?
Okay. So we see multi-tenant SaaS applications because those are good examples of apps that tend to grow really fast and need that scale at some point along in their evolution. And SaaS apps typically like to run in the cloud, right? So they kind of want to outsource the database operations, let somebody else take care of security and backups and all of the data protection things that need to happen. And so SaaS apps is probably number one. Number two, I would say, are real-time analytics dashboards. So think of customer-facing dashboards where there's a lot of concurrency. There are a lot of users hitting that dashboard at the same time, doing interactive queries. They don't want some like pre-baked dashboard that was created a couple of days ago on data that's a couple of days old. They want to do interactive queries on real-time data, data that some people call fresh, that's just been ingested and can already be queried in order to, you know, answer their questions. So we see a lot of those applications, and they ultimately need the kind of parallelization that you can get by using a distributed database. That is Postgres. And then we'll sometimes see IoT applications where those IoT applications also need the benefits of a relational database. They need updates, they need joins, things like that. And then there's just super high throughput transactional applications that just need the kind of scale that you can get out of distributed Postgres.
Awesome. So let's double click a little bit into this scale side. You know, how large can a Citus cluster get?
Oh, that's actually a really good question. So there's a blog post that I wrote called Architecting Petabyte Scale Analytics by, you know, Scaling Up Postgres with Citus. There's a customer actually at Microsoft that was a customer before the acquisition, right? Before I worked for Microsoft. And he uses Citus and Postgres, and he runs it on Azure and is for a database that is multiple petabytes. And so I he's not the only one. We have other customers I could talk about where they have these petabyte scale platforms. And so when you have a distributed database, when you have, you know, 60 nodes that are all serving your application, obviously you can grow really, really big. And in his case, I'm looking at the actual details in the footnotes right now. His application needs to support about 10 million queries a day with like 20,000 different diagnostic metrics. And he has hundreds of concurrent users who are all hitting that dashboard at the same time. And I believe it's about 60 nodes. I'll look that up while we're talking here. So things can grow big. But I think one of the exciting things also with Citus is that earlier this year, you and I talked on Data Exposed Live back in like May. Yeah. And there was a Citus 10 release that we issued that had some pretty, I don't know, exciting new capabilities. And one of them was this ability to shard Postgres on a single node. So even when you're just getting started, even when you know you're going to need to scale later this year or sometime next year, you can actually start to use Citus to shard and to parallelize your workload on a single node. And that makes it much easier to transition to a distributed database later when you need to.
Cool. Awesome. That's very cool. So, you know, Claire, this has been really useful because I've gotten to learn and our viewers have gotten to learn a little bit about the Citus use cases and some of the great benefits. You know, I just have to ask, like, is there a situation where you would say, you know, maybe Citus isn't the best solution for an application?
I think if your application isn't growing, if it doesn't need to scale, then you might not ever need to use Citus if you don't expect to have demanding performance requirements at any point in time. So there are some applications that work really, really well on a single node and that app's not growing. And they might not ever need to use Citus. But what we find when we talk to customers is even if they're not growing now, they plan to, they expect to. And they want the improved performance that you can get from the parallelization and from sharding.
Awesome. No, I think that's a great answer. And I think like everything, the answer is generally like, it depends on your scenario. So this has been really useful. You know, as we start to wrap up the episode, I wanted to ask if you had any final tips, tricks, advice that you wanted to share with our viewers about Citus.
I have a couple of things. I want to share some of the ways you can get started. So let me see if I can share anything here. We put together a bunch of materials. People learn in different ways. So whether you like to read documentation or watch demos or, you know, roll up your sleeves and try the tutorials and download the open source packages, we have this wonderful getting started page that my team has created. And I have a short form URL showing on screen right now that'll show you how to get there. And there's just all sorts of useful information there. The Citus docs are pretty awesome too. A lot of our users have kind of given those a plus one and said thank you to the team that writes them. So that's one thing I wanted to point out. Also, if you are interested in extensions to Postgres and how those work, how those use the Postgres extension APIs, and you want to understand why we built Citus the way we built it, why it's architected the way it is, this is a super useful video that just got published that was created by the technical lead of the open source project. And so I put another short form URL on the screen too, if you want to go watch how Citus distributes Postgres. And it's based on a Sigmod paper that actually Marco and team delivered just a couple months ago as well. So that's the second thing. And the third thing I wanted to flag is that earlier this year in Citus 10, we added new columnar storage capabilities to Citus, which is pretty powerful. And if you have 10 minutes, actually it could be a little bit more than that, but and you want to watch a demo of what it is and what it does, Jeff Davis, who's the architect of that feature, he created this video and I put a short URL there too. So those are the three things I wanted to share.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Claire. This has been really informational. I know some users are going to want to go deeper in this. I want them all to know that we put links to all of the things Claire talked about in the description. So you're definitely going to want to check those out. Claire, again, just thanks so much for joining us. This was really useful. I think our viewers found it useful. To our viewers, if you like this video, go ahead, give it a like, subscribe to our channel, leave us a comment and let us know what you think of Citus. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.